And then I found Lizzie moaning and groaning outside the infirmary.
You know she does carry on,
Meg. Well, not this time. She looked really ill. And she has exactly the same symptoms as Sister Franklin. I'm really worried, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, what do you think it is?
Well, remember that visit we had from the health inspector? He said Jenny Hamilton was on the same plane where they discovered that tropical disease.
Well, you don't think Lizzie has typhoid?
Well, she could, couldn't she? I mean, she has all the symptoms, just like Sister.
Well, I hope you're wrong.
I don't think I am.
Well, I'd better call the health department at once. We have an epidemic on our hands.
Smith to see you, Mrs. Davidson.
Well, just one moment.
It's urgent, Mrs. Davidson. It's about this sickness Lizzie's got.
Mrs. Morris has already called a doctor.
You think he'll know what's causing it?
What do you mean?
It's not my way to lag on the other women, as you know, but I think Lizzie's been poisoned.
By whom?
That crackpot Randel. She's been brewing up medicines from plants and things, and she slipped something to Lizzie.
I understand the doctor from the infectious diseases hospital has arrived.
Yes, he's in there examining Randel and Birdsworth.
Oh, you'd better not go in.
I am the governor, Erica Davidson.
I'm Sister Haynes. I work with Dr. Granger. He shouldn't be long.
What are these for?
Routine tests. We'll have to test everybody who's been in contact with the sick women.
What are you looking for exactly?
Well, we're not sure yet. We'll start with the most common things, of course. Enteric fever, dengue fever, cholera. From the symptoms shown by the woman on the plane, enteric fever's the most likely. You'll know it as typhoid. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll see if the doctor's finished.
Have you had a heart checkup lately, Mrs. Birdsworth?
Of course. And I take my pills regular, too.
And what sort of pills are you taking?
Oh, I don't know. Red ones.
The governor's waiting outside to see you, Doctor.
All right. Take a blood sample from both of them, would you? Then we'll put them on antibiotics.
What's wrong with me, Doctor?
Well, that's what we're here to find out, Mrs. Birdsworth. We'll have to do a few tests first.
Oh, that means they don't know, Lizzie. They're groping around in the dark.
Just following normal scientific procedures, Mrs. Randel. We leave the home remedies and quackery to the fringe practitioners.
I suppose you've never lost a patient.
Not through incompetence.
Oh, incompetence? How would anybody know? You lot all stick together. You cover up your mistakes. It's only people like me who end up in jail.
Unfortunately, your patients fare even worse. I can't pretend I don't know who you are, Mrs. Randel. But right now you're in my care, and I'd prefer you didn't upset yourself. You have a medical record for Mrs. Birdsworth?
Yes, it's in the file. I'll get it for you.
I want to check her heart condition and medication before I give her any drugs.
Is it typhoid?
Well, it's too soon to say. The woman on the plane was only admitted to hospital 3 days ago. It takes 5 days at least to get a positive result from typhoid tests. In the meantime, we'll give them antibiotics anyway.
You're sure that Birdsworth and Randel are suffering from the same disease as this woman?
No, but the early symptoms are the same. Fever and diarrhea. And they've been in contact with the prisoner on the plane.
Jenny Armstrong?
Yes.
Have you found her yet?
No. Oh, thanks. And she could be anywhere. If she is the carrier, we could have a full-scale epidemic on our hands. I'd like a full list of everyone who came into contact with Armstrong while she was here.
Well, there weren't that many, really. That was myself, Mrs. Morris, Officer Barfield, when she came in, the two police who drove the paddy wagon, and the two other prisoners, Randel and Baxter.
Mrs. Birdsworth never came into contact with her?
Oh, yes, when she delivered her food in the hospital. That's when Sister Franklin saw her, too.
So Armstrong was sick then?
No, she was only had some cuts and some bruising. One of the other women, Baxter, attacked her in the paddy wagon.
And where's Baxter now?
Well, she's in solitary.
Look, what good do you think this is going to do? I thought you understood. If you don't do the test, you don't get out of solitary.
Don't care.
Then why have you been crying?
Haven't.
It's no good trying to fight the system.
Just bug off!
Look, things would be much easier for you, Georgie, if you cooperated. You must see that.
Won't bloody lecture me. You teachers are all the same. I had a gutful of you when I was a kid. Do this or I'll belt you around the ear. And you know how to do this or I'll keep you locked up.
It isn't like that.
How is it then? Do I get out of here if I don't do that test? No, of course I bloody don't.
You're just making it difficult for yourself.
I'm making it difficult for you, you mean?
George.
Trouble, Mr. Andrews?
No. We were just deciding which classes Georgie should attend. Weren't we, Georgie?
Well, I'm afraid that'll have to wait. Baxter, you have to see the doctor.
What?
You have to see the doctor.
What for?
It's just a routine examination.
What, having no doctor poking around with me?
It's just routine. You weren't examined when you arrived here.
I'm not going to be examined now.
Georgie, be sensible.
No!
You'll see that doctor or I'll carry you there.
Right. You get away from me, you bastard.
Georgie.
Just get away!
Georgie!
You bastard! Put me down! Put me...
Excuse me, Mr. Andrews.
Down, you bastard! I hate you!
Now, this won't hurt. Thank you, sister. Now, this is an antibiotic. It's best that you all have one. If it is typhoid, then the antibiotic will start working straight away. If not, well, it won't harm you. There. That didn't hurt, did it?
Mrs. Davidson, yes. I was just going off duty, and the garden and the gates refused to allow me to leave the grounds.
Oh, that's my fault, I'm afraid. Until we find out exactly what we're dealing with, nobody will be coming in or going out of the prison. As you probably know, typhoid is transferable by food. And so the first steps will be to destroy all supplies of unpackaged food. Meat, bread, anything that could have been touched.
Is that necessary? Jenny Armstrong wasn't even in the kitchen.
No, but Mrs. Birdsworth was.
Oh, of course. Well, it's going to be very expensive.
And it's better than having this thing spread. So far, it seems to have been confined to H block. So this area will be cut off completely from the rest of the prison. Food will be brought in, but nothing goes out. Dirty plates, knives, forks, everything stays here.
Including us?
Including you. We'll have to make arrangements for everyone to sleep here.
There isn't the room.
There would be if people doubled up, including those in solitary and isolation.
Yes, well, the female officers can sleep in isolation. The men will have to go to the solitary cells. I'm afraid the bunks aren't very comfortable.
We'll manage.
But what about Baxter? You can't put her in with anyone. She's like an animal.
Well, I think Judy Bryant could handle her.
Oh, she could handle her, all right.
I didn't mean that.
That's enough. What do you think, Mr. Fletcher?
Well, I think Mrs. Morris is right. I don't think Baxter will cause any trouble with anyone who can fight back.
Well, will you look after that? Is there anything else?
Not unless you have any questions.
How will we know if we're getting this thing?
Well, the first symptoms are fever and diarrhea. You should be all right with the immunization, but if you feel strange, temperature, headache, anything at all, come and see me straight away.
Right.
What I don't understand is why Baxter's not sick. She was in the wagon with Armstrong and Randel, and she was in direct contact with Armstrong.
Well, that's hard to say. Some people aren't affected by typhoid. They're the carriers. Their own symptoms are no more than those of a slight cold. That could be the case with Baxter, assuming we are dealing with typhoid. We don't even know that yet.
Yeah, well, that's my point. One of the prisoners claims that Birdsworth was poisoned.
It's possible, but it's not likely. All the indications at the moment are that it is typhoid.
And when will we know?
2 or 3 days.
And meanwhile, we're stuck in here. We're no better off than the prisoners.
In fact, you're worse off. They don't have to work.
Is Lizzie gonna die, B?
How the hell should I know?
Well, I just think it's awful. I mean, Lizzie, well, she's family.
Will you shut up about it, Doreen? We're all worried about her. Talking about it isn't gonna help.
I was just thinking out loud. But you were wrong about one thing, though. Evelyn couldn't have poisoned her.
Yeah, who says?
Well, Evelyn's sick too. She wouldn't poison herself, would she?
Well, that muck she's been brewing up in her cell, anything's possible.
I suppose you want some of my coffee.
Well, it is your turn.
Hey, B, I just tried to take this book back to the library.
So?
Well, the gates were locked. They wouldn't let me through. They wouldn't even take the book from me. Said it might be infected. Now, I don't know what's wrong with Evelyn and Lizzie, but I think it's pretty serious.
Lizzie is gonna die, isn't she, B?
What is it, Lizzie?
Oh, I'm so hot. I can't breathe. I feel so weak.
Oh, it's just the fever, Lizzie. It'll come down soon. I'll give you another injection. That should help.
The last one didn't do much good.
These things take time, Mrs. Randall.
Oh, really? Well, you're not pumping me with anything. You haven't got a clue what you're doing. I could cure us both while you're still doing your ridiculous tests.
I don't think that's very likely, Mrs. Randall.
Oh, really? You let me get back to my cell and I'll show you.
This is a hospital, not a witch doctor's tent. Now, if you've got any sense at all, you'll let me give you another injection.
No.
If you don't, you could die.
Then I'll die. Wonder if they'll stick you in here for losing a patient.
The only reason you'll die is because of your own stupidity. Besides, I have a witness to the fact that you're refusing treatment.
That is, if you don't kill her, too.
I'm going to report this to the doctor.
I reckon you're crazy, Ev. I'd let her do anything to me if it didn't make me better.
It's a big if, Lizzie.
Come on, Hamilton, collect your things. You're being moved back in with the others.
About bloody time. How come Mrs. Davidson changed her mind? Was she afraid I might write something about her when I got out?
The way things are going, you may never get out to write anything.
What do you mean?
You'll find out. Now hurry up.
Hey, what's going on, Vera?
What do you think's going on? Hamilton's being moved back in with the rest of you.
So why are we locked in here? We're in quarantine or something.
That's right.
Quarantine? Oh, is someone sick?
What is it? Is it serious?
Lizzie might die. Is that serious enough for you?
Get inside.
I'm not going in there.
I haven't got all day to mess around with you. Get inside.
No, I will not, and you can't make me. If I go in there, I'll get sick. No, I want to go back to isolation.
Well, isn't that just too bad? Now, come on.
No! Just let go of me. You're deliberately trying to make me get sick. Look, Vera, I won't write anything about you in the papers. I promise. Now, please take me back to isolation.
What's the matter, Sandy? Aren't we good enough for you?
Yeah, our germs are just as good as anybody else.
Now, get inside!
Come on, spray
again. Get inside! Will you shut up?
Oh, I'm sorry, Vera. Listen, do you want a hand?
That's enough of that.
Just trying to help.
Hey, Doreen, pick up her gear.
Yeah, babe.
Who's she sharing with, anyway? You and Burns.
Oh. Well, now, isn't that nice?
You're no worse off in here than you were in isolation. Birdsworth's been bringing you your food for days. If you were going to catch anything from her, you'd have got it by now.
Mind you, that is her bed you're sitting on. It's probably loaded with germs.
That's enough of that. We're all in the same situation and nobody gets out of here until this is all over.
And when we do, it'll probably be in a box.
Get out of my way.
Hey, Doreen, give Sandy her stuff.
Yeah, sure. Here you are, Sandra.
It'll be full of germs by now.
Is that any way to treat Doreen when she's trying to be polite? That's how we survive in here, you know, by helping one another.
Yeah, I thought you wanted to know what life was really like inside.
Oh, she's finding out. She's finding out the screws can do anything they like lock you in and expose you to germs.
You know something? You'll be able to write a really good story when you get out of here.
Yeah.
It's if you live long enough.
What's going on in here?
Oh, we're just welcoming our new cellmate, Mr. Fletcher.
You all right, Hamilton?
What do you care? You're going to kill me one way or the other.
Well, she's frightened of getting sick and dying.
Yeah, that's something we all have to live with, Smith. Bryant, you follow me. The rest of you that don't belong in here, outside.
Fun playing God, isn't it? Not too good when you're on the other side, though, huh? Oh, I'll pick up the things and give them to her, Doreen.
Baxter? You know Baxter, don't you, Bryant? Well, she'll be sharing your cell with you. Now, we chose Bryant because she's bigger than you are. So don't try anything. It'll be lights out in a minute.
You don't want to pay any attention to him, love. He just said that to scare you.
I ain't scared.
Not even of getting sick?
I never get sick.
Yeah, that's what I used to say. Then one day, pow. Now, I am a bionic woman. It's the truth. I got a pacemaker in here. I'm nuclear powered.
Go on, will you? Think I am stupid?
No, you want to see? I'll show you the scar.
Ah. What's it like having a pacemaker?
Well, I can tell you one thing, it's better than not having one. Sometimes when I lie in bed at night, you know, in a funny position, I can feel it, but otherwise it gives me no trouble. I can do most things. Want some coffee?
Nah. I wouldn't mind a biscuit, but...
Oh, sure, love. Help yourself. Take two if you like.
Thanks. Want a cup, V?
Yeah, sure. Thanks, love.
What about you?
No.
What's it to you?
Doreen has to pay for that coffee. 2 days work for one lousy tin.
Well, you're drinking it.
And tomorrow she'll be drinking mine. Now, have you got any?
You know I haven't.
Well, then there's something else you've learned about being in prison. If you ain't got nothing, no one is going to give you nothing.
Here, B.
Thanks, love. Oh, that tastes good.
Will you just lay off? You've had your fun. So you know that I'm frightened of being sick. Well, so what?
We're all afraid of being sick.
Yeah, well, not like I am.
Oh?
Look, I nursed my mother when she was ill. I just had to sit there and watch her waste away in front of my eyes. There was nothing I could do for her. There was nothing anyone could do. I had to sit and watch her suffer and then die.
What'd she die of?
Cancer.
Getting along in here all right?
Well, yes, Vera, as a matter of fact, we are. I'm sorry to disappoint you.
Lights up in 5 minutes. Lights up in 5 minutes.
Don't you have any pajamas?
What?
Don't you have pajamas?
No.
Oh, well, I'll get you some.
Yeah, where? Can I have another biscuit?
Oh, sure, I'll help yourself.
Is that how you buy them, Bryant? With biscuits?
Yeah, that's right, Vera. You want a nibble?
You're disgusting.
Who are you calling disgusting?
Oh, don't pay any attention.
You want to see something disgusting? I'll show you. I'll bash your head.
A lesbian.
What's the matter? Get it on yourself,
Vera.
That rotten bitch.
See
your face.
Yeah, it's okay.
Nice sharing with you. Gets you lonely at night sometimes.
Yeah, I know.
Good night.
Good night, Georgie.
I said good night.
Good night.
Are you all right?
Oh, yes, it's this epidemic. It's making me a bit jumpy, that's all. How are the rounds?
Oh, marvellous. Baxter's getting along famously with Bryant.
Oh, good.
Good. She was just dancing around half naked in front of her.
Oh, you can't change the way people are, Vera.
It's disgusting.
Probably. There's a nightdress and dressing gown for you on the bed.
Well, where did these come from?
They're prison issue. It's the last they had.
Are yours prison issue?
No. Bob dropped a couple of them in for me at the gate.
Must be nice to have someone to drop things in. He could have got something for me.
How would he have got into your flat? The doctor wouldn't have let you send the key out.
He could have asked the landlord.
Oh, Vera, for heaven's sake. I don't want to argue with you. I'm sorry, it's just that I'm a bit tense. I don't feel very well, actually.
You're not sick, are you?
Oh, I'm just a bit on edge, I think.
You've got a temperature, I'll call the doctor.
Look, I'm fine, he's got enough to do.
He said that if any of us were feeling the slightest bit strange, we should call him. Now, you wait here. Well?
The same symptoms, I'm afraid. In fact, the temperature's even higher than the other two. I can't understand it. She's been immunized.
Sorry, Mrs. Davidson.
So am I. But I'm sure you couldn't help it.
No.
Take her down, please, sister.
Where are you taking her?
The prison hospital.
But there are prisoners there.
As I'm concerned, they're all sick people. They'll all be treated the same way. Although, if we have any more cases, we shall have to make other arrangements. There won't be room in the hospital.
I don't like it, Mrs. Davidson. Prisoners and officers sleeping in the same room.
In the circumstances, we have no choice.
And where am I going to sleep now? I can't sleep in a room where Meg fell sick.
Well, the only other alternative is one of the solitary cells.
The men are up there.
Well, you can always close the door. In any case, I doubt whether anyone will get much sleep tonight.
Mrs. Davidson. Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, Mr. Fletcher. What time is it?
It's about 7:30. Are you all right?
Oh, yes, I'm fine. I didn't get much sleep. Officer Barfield fell ill and I took over her shift.
He should have woken me.
Oh, you have enough to do today with Officer Barfield and Mrs. Morrisill. Fortunately, none of the other prisoners were affected, so that's a good thing.
But if you don't get some sleep, you'll be the next.
Oh, nonsense. I'll be all right as soon as I've had a shower and freshened up. I'll use the women's showers as soon as they're safely in the dining room.
Well, they're already there, but I don't think they're very happy about it.
Why not?
Well, we couldn't give them any of the food that Dr. Granger wanted destroyed, and, well, the alternative wasn't exactly their choice.
You don't expect us to eat this muck, do you, Vera?
You can please yourself.
Oh, I will. Get us a cuppa, will you, love?
Sure.
I'd give breakfast a miss this morning if I were you, Jude. Yeah,
I think you're right. Anyway, I can afford to lose a few pounds, eh?
Oh,
you
want a cup of tea?
Oh, thanks, Annie.
Got her train pretty quickly.
Yes, she's okay.
Bit dumb, though.
Here, babe.
Thanks, love.
And how's your roommate?
Well, she's so scared she wouldn't come out of her cell. Frightened she might catch something.
Thanks, Annie.
Attention, everybody. Because of the quarantine, work in the laundry has been cancelled.
What for?
Because nothing you launder can be sent out of here. We might be transmitting germs. Instead, I want some volunteers. One group to disinfect the place, the other to burn all the food that has to be destroyed.
Okay, this table starts the bonfire. That is, of course, if no one else objects.
All right, the rest of you can clean the place.
Has this sugar been brought in fresh?
No, that's old stock.
And I'm afraid it'll have to be disposed of too.
Bryant, you better take a rest. Go on, take a break. Where do you think you're going, Baxter? Baxter!
Actually, I'd like a word with her, if you don't mind, you.
You're all right, but don't keep her too long. She's got work to do.
Thanks.
Oh, that's bloody marvellous. It leaves Doreen and me to do all the work.
Yeah, well, you better get on with it, Smith. You too, Burns. Come on, hop to it.
How come if you got this pacemaker thing to make you feel better, you feel so tired?
Georgie?
What do you want?
I've been looking at your test paper. I had to stick it together again first, of course. You'd answered all your sums, but none of your written questions. Why was that?
Mind your own bloody business.
Georgie, I'm just trying to help. I think you might have a learning problem.
The only problem I've got is you keeping on at me. Just bugger off, will you?
No, please.
Just bugger off!
Baxter!
It's all right, Jim. What I wanted to ask you is, can you read?
Why don't you ask her that later? She's a bit uptight now. We all are. We're all getting frightened and getting sick.
Yeah, perhaps you're right. But I'll be back.
Bloody teachers are all the same.
Can you read, love?
I can write my name and that, but I didn't get a chance to learn anything else. Didn't spend much time at school. And when I was there, all the teachers did was bash me round the head.
All right, Baxter, come on. Mr. Andrews is gone now.
Why don't you go and help Bela?
Okay.
Dr. Granger! Dr. Granger, would you come quickly, please?
Make sure all this food is burnt properly, Mr. Fletcher.
Right.
Take over, please, sister. Same, I'm afraid. There's no more room in the prison hospital. From now on, we'll have to use the cells as temporary wards.
But
I just don't understand it. These women were never near Armstrong, and they were immunized.
Well, the answer may be that we're not dealing with typhoid. I've just had a call from the isolation hospital. The woman on the plane died a few minutes ago.
It is imperative the prisoners do not find out about this woman dying. They could panic and riot trying to get out of
here.
Yes,
I agree.
Yes, there are already signs of breakdown and discipline. The women know that we can't punish them effectively under the circumstances. Do you want me to confiscate the radios and the television?
No, no, that won't be necessary. The health department is withholding the news of her death until after an autopsy has been completed. Then we'll know exactly where we stand.
Right. Bye-bye. The hospital agrees that it may not be typhoid. Otherwise, we'll be getting a better response from the antibiotics. They want us to tighten the hygiene procedure even further. Close down the kitchens entirely. Mm. Food will be brought to the gate ready cooked, and we'll pick it up from there. Since the epidemic seems to be confined to H-block, we'll pick up our food separately.
Right. Would you handle the security arrangements, Mr. Fletcher? We'll need an armed guard.
Well, I'd better take care of that myself. The other officers aren't too keen on firearms.
When can we expect the result of the autopsy?
That depends. Could be hours, could be days. At any rate, the tests we did on her when she was first admitted will have matured by tomorrow. At least then we'll know if it's typhoid.
And in the meantime?
Keep on with the antibiotics, just in case. Although the results are pretty haphazard. And Mrs. Birdsworth seems to be getting better, but Mrs. Morris is much worse. And Mrs. Randel, who's refused any sort of treatment at all, seems to be doing better than any of them.
Well, I reckon you're stupid. I've been taking his antibiotics and I feel better.
Oh, will you be quiet, Lizzie?
Okay, well, I know he's only a young bloke and that you could teach him a thing or two, but his cure's working on me.
Well, it isn't working on Mrs. Morris, is it?
No. Well, it's just a matter of time.
It won't work. No matter how much time you give it, I know.
How do you know?
Because I know it's not the right treatment. That's all. Look, I've seen this sort of thing when I was overseas. I know what'll cure her. I've got some stuff in my cell now.
Well, the doc's not going to let you use your stuff on her. Bloody pity, though. She's the best screw in the whole place.
I'm going to get the stuff now.
Oh, you can't. They'll stop you.
There's nobody here to stop me, is there?
Somewhere, Mrs. Randel?
Yes, I want to go to the bathroom.
There are bedpans in the ward.
You can't keep me here. I'm not your patient. I'm not taking your medicine. I demand to be put back in my cell.
I'm afraid that's not possible.
You can't stop me. You've no right.
Well, that's where you're wrong. In matters like this, I'm in complete charge.
Well, I'm a sick woman. Your medicine isn't working. Now, Mrs. Morris could die. I can cure her and I can cure myself.
Not while you're my patient.
I am not your patient.
If you die, I'll be held responsible. You're not taking anything that I haven't prescribed.
You are a stupid, narrow-minded fool. You don't know what you're doing. You could kill us all before you admit you're wrong. I demand to see the governor.
You're not seeing anybody. You're going back to bed.
I am not. Well, just you remember. If Mrs. Morris dies, you killed her. Stupid fool.
I told you he wouldn't let you do it.
Oh, will you shut up, Lizzie?
Next time Mrs. Randel leaves the room, would you call out Mrs. Birdsworth?
Yes, Doctor.
Not that it'll make much difference. From now on, there'll be someone on duty at all times in the examination room.
Say I'd call out. I wouldn't really.
Oh, that's all right. If that means he trusts you. You can get the stuff for me.
Oh, no.
Oh, come on.
Oh, no. I've been in here for over 20 years for poisoning. I didn't even do it, and I'm not going to give anything to Mrs. Morris.
Lizzie, you'll be saving her life.
Yeah. Well, I suppose you know what you're doing. But you did do in one of your patients once before, didn't you? If I gave some of that stuff to Mrs. Morris and she died, God, I'd never forgive myself.
Oh, hey, Jude. Do you want a cup of coffee? Seeing as how you missed out on your tea this morning.
Yeah, thanks.
Ask your little friend if she wants one.
Anybody in there? Want some coffee?
No, thanks.
Okay, then. There you go.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, Maureen. Looks like you missed out again, Sandy. Only three cups. Oh. What are you looking for, anyway?
Reports on this epidemic. Someone out there must know what's going on in here.
You'll never learn, will you? No one knows. No one cares.
Well, what about that woman who was taken into the quarantine hospital? Somebody knows about her. And if they're not, if they're keeping that a secret, it's because she's dead.
Hey, quick, Fletcher's coming. Let's put us away before he confiscates our bloody lot.
You say anything, you'll be sorry.
Right, now, because of this epidemic, we've decided to close down the kitchen completely. From now on, all food will be brought in ready-cooked.
That could only be an improvement.
That's enough out of you, Smith. Now, I'm looking for a volunteer to take food to the prison hospital. How about you, Hamilton?
Me? You've got to be joking. I shouldn't even be in here with them, let alone working in the sick rooms.
I'll take it, Mr. Fletcher.
Yeah, we all will.
Oh, that won't be necessary. You only need one person. We're only delivering food to the sick. Come on, Doreen. The rest of you be ready at reception at lunchtime to take delivery of food from the caterers. That includes you too, Hamilton. There's no danger. Come on.
Here we go.
Oh, thanks, Doreen.
Breakfast, ladies. Oh, look, serve them, would you? I won't be a moment. Just put Mrs. Morris' breakfast beside her bed.
How you feeling?
Okay, bloody hungry, though. How come Bricky's so late?
I don't know. Suppose they reckon you sickies need your sleep.
Oh, lovely.
Oh, it's cold. What did you expect? I had to carry it all the way from the main gate, and you should have seen what we had for breakfast. Lumpy porridge without sugar.
Doreen, there's something I want you to get for me from my cell.
What is it?
It's like in a small screw-top coffee jar with something in it that looks like boiled greens.
What do you want it for?
It's medicine.
Doctor said you're not allowed to have that medicine.
Will you shut up, Lizzie?
Well, why don't you have some of the doc's medicine?
Because it's no good. Go over and try and wake Mrs. Morris.
What for?
Look, tell her you've got her breakfast.
But the nurse said that
Doreen,
I had...
would you do it?
Mrs. Morris?
Shake her harder.
Mrs. Morris?
No, you will never wake her. She's in a coma. She'll be dead within 24 hours.
She's not responding. Just about confirms that it's not typhoid. The question is, what the hell is it? You'd better put on a drip, get some nourishment into her.
Yes, Doctor.
I'll check with the hospital, see if the tests have shown up anything.
She's going to die, isn't she?
Not if I can help it. Although you look as though you'd be glad if she does. Hardly the attitude for someone who calls herself a healer.
I could heal her if you'd let me.
No. Sister Haynes, if you hear one more mention of Mrs. Randall's miraculous cure, let me know. I'll have one of the solitary cells turned into a ward, and we'll send her up there.
What are you doing?
Try and find my pulse.
Yeah, well, it's there somewhere. If you were dead, someone would have told you. Now, will you play a card?
Well, I feel funny.
We all feel funny. You can't hardly help with it when I'm flaking out around us. Come on, it's your turn.
It's that. Kitty! Now I can beat that, either.
Clever little devil, aren't you?
How many?
Nice.
Terrific. That's 36 cigarettes you owe us.
Bloody marvellous, isn't it?
Hey, B, can I talk to you?
Why change the habit of a lifetime?
Well, it's about Evelyn. She wants me to smuggle some medicine into her when I take the lunches. Do you reckon I should do it?
What medicine?
Some stuff from her cell.
No, don't do it.
But I've got to do something, because Mrs. Morris is dying.
Who says she is?
Evelyn.
Oh, and she'd know, of course.
Well, it might be worth a try,
no, B. No, no. B's right. If something went wrong, then Doreen could be up on a murder charge.
Yeah.
But what if Mrs. Morris dies anyway?
Look, I said no. Now, will you shove off? I'm trying to play cards.
Right, come on, Jude, it's your lead. I'm going to try and win those cigarettes back somehow.
Want a bet?
Well, your temperature's normal. Though your pulse is a little fast, I'll give you something.
Does this mean I've got that plague?
It is not the plague, Miss Hamilton. You're just overwrought. I'll give you a mild tranquilizer.
Oh, I don't want a tranquilizer. Look, I'm sick. I want to get out of this place.
That's impossible. You could spread the disease.
Then I am sick.
You are not sick. Just distraught. Now, you take a few of these pills and you'll
find... Look, I don't want them!
Trouble, Dr. Granger?
Mrs. Davidson, I want to get out of here.
That's impossible.
I've already told her that.
Well, then I want to make a phone call.
Wait outside.
I demand to make a phone call.
Wait outside. How is Mrs. Morris?
No better, I'm afraid. Just seems to be wasting away. Our tests haven't managed to isolate any virus at all as yet.
And is Hamilton suffering from the same disease?
Oh, no. Just signs of an overdeveloped imagination. The entire block's in here every 30 minutes asking for a checkup.
Yes?
I'm sorry to bother you, Mrs. Davidson. We're not feeling too well, Doc.
See what I mean? All right, you better come in. All of you.
I'll leave you to it. What's this about a phone call, Hamilton?
I'm entitled to one phone call a week.
Under normal circumstances, that is true.
Normal or not, I want my phone call.
Whom do you want to phone?
My editor. Somebody's got to know what's happening here. There's nothing about it in the papers. There's nothing on the news.
That is because we don't want any further panic. There's been quite enough of that already. I'm sorry, your request is denied.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, then please put me back in isolation.
There isn't any room.
Oh, but please, I won't write about anything that happens here. I promise I won't. Please put me back in isolation because I know you're just trying to kill me.
That is ridiculous.
No, you are. You are trying to kill me because you don't want me to write about it.
Are you ill, Kent?
No, Mrs. Davidson. Just nerves.
Obviously, there's far too much imagination being brought to bear here. You all right?
Yeah. Hey, I reckon Mrs. Davidson just slapped Sandra across the face.
Oh, she wouldn't.
I was standing in the corridor and Sandra was holding her cheek. Maybe Davo's getting uptight. You'd be surprised if everybody falling sick around here.
Yeah, it's real spooky, isn't it?
Do you reckon Evelyn's medicine would cure Mrs. Morris?
I don't know. I don't want to find out either, because Bea'd kill me if I took some of that stuff into her.
Yeah, but if it works, we could all take it. I don't fancy getting sick.
I don't fancy a thump from Bea, neither.
She wouldn't know.
She'd find out. Anyway, if you're so bloody keen, why don't you take it into her?
It's nothing to do with me. I thought you wanted to help Mrs. Morris.
I do.
Right, now take the sheets off that bed and put your own on.
Hey, that's Bea's bed.
Yeah, well, Smith's sick, so is Bryant. We're turning Bryant's cell into a temporary ward for them both. You'll be sharing with Baxter.
Judy be all right?
Yes, I should think so.
Bea and Judy are both sick. We're bound to get it.
Yeah. We've got to try Evelyn's medicine now. Bea can't stop you if she's sick. It's up to you, Dor.
Baxter. If you've got so much energy, report to reception. You can help bring the food in from the main gate. Well, go on, move it! What's going on, Doreen?
Oh, nothing, Mr. Fletcher. It's like I said. She's mad. She should still be in the pound.
Well, there's not enough room. Besides, everybody's edgy at the moment. Just try and keep out of her way, okay?
How am I supposed to do that when we share the same cell?
What are you doing in here anyway?
Evelyn said I could come in and water her plants.
Well, when you finish that, report to reception. You've got to take the lunches to the prison hospital. Where's Baxter?
Oh, she wasn't in reception. She's gone to see our Judy's.
Well, we'll have to manage without her. Someone will have to make a couple of extra trips.
Charming.
Careful, Cantor, it'll be you. All right, Hamilton, Stokes, when I tell you, you'll move forward and pick up the food that's been left under the barrier. Then Officer Barry will accompany you back to the building. Then you'll come back here for an extra load. Thanks, Ted. All right.
Do you think he'd use that rifle?
Fletcher? Shoot his own grandmother. Got his training in Vietnam, shooting women and kids.
All right, Hamilton, Stokes.
No, we've got to go back for more. Fletcher's waiting for us with a bloody rifle.
A rifle? Geez, things must be bad. The screws hate carrying guns.
That's enough, Burns. Get this stuff inside. Come on, Hamilton, move it.
Here we are, ladies. Lunch. I'll help you, Doreen. Here you are. Oh, chicken. You'd better eat it before it gets any colder. Here we are, Lizzie.
Oh, thanks.
Do something.
What?
Get the jar out.
Nurse, come quick. Judy's breathing funny. I'll be with you in a minute.
Come now or else.
Oh, all right. Come on.
Good, now take the top off. Right, now pour some of the liquid into her mouth.
Oh, I don't know.
No, do it, do it.
Oh, for heaven's sake, it's perfectly all right. Look. Right, now give her some.
Why don't you do it?
Because if they find me out of bed, they'll know something's wrong, and all you've got to do is hide the jar. Now get on with it. Go on.
I'm afraid the fever comes and goes. You're just going through a bad spell.
Yeah, what sure sells isn't a good one, is it?
She gonna be all right? Yes, this happens to everyone.
Yeah, but they're all still sick, aren't they?
I think you'd better leave.
No, I'm staying.
Very well. I'll get the doctor.
You'll be all right, Jude.
Of course I will, honey.
Is it Victor Pacemaker?
I hope not.
Keep running, Hamilton. You're going to force me to.
give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines.